Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel where skincare is all about progression over perfection because perfection doesn't exist. If you've watched any of my Instagram versus reality videos, you would know that there are a lot of brands, not just influencers, who are okay with lies and manipulation and filters in order to sell their product. And why am I doing this series? Because I believe when brands are making a profit from their products and making a profit from us, they're taking our money, we need to know what works, we need to know the real effects. Also, I'm petty as f***. And in this new series, Brands Who Lie, or Brands That Lie, we'll check the grammar when we're doing the title. And in this video, I'll be testing products from those brands that lie. Brands that fake results, brands that use filters, brands that use different products that look like their products in order to give a better result. And to kick off the series, we're going to be using the most recent controversial product, the Tarte Timeless Smoothing Primer. Now, why this product? Well, in a still pretty recent Instagram post on Tarte Cosmetics Instagram, they uploaded a video in which Shana, who I presume is a member of the social media marketing team, I'm not actually sure, I should have checked that, shows us how to use the Timeless Smoothing Primer to erase pores. That's a red flag there already.
Hey, watch me shrink my pores instantly. Look at the results that you're seeing right here. This is not a filter. Oily skin, textured skin. Meet your new best friend. It's our Timeless Smoothing Primer. It's like a filter without a filter.
However, this video was called out by so many people, including myself, for the super painfully obvious, poorly done filter used to promote and exaggerate the effects of this primer. In fact, this poorly used filter was so outrageous and so ridiculous that it made BuzzFeed news. It all kicked off on Twitter. My tweet, someone else's tweet, Jamila Jamil ended up replying to my tweet because it's just so obvious. In my opinion, legally. Oh, everything in this video is my opinion. For legal reasons, allegedly. Tarte were pretty much forced to make a statement because of how everything kicked off in their comments over on Twitter. But in that statement, they said that they didn't use filters, which in my personal opinion is absolute bullshit. It's there, we can see it. Is very obvious. And in fact, they did actually delete the reel off their main grid, but you can still see it on the reels. Later that day, Tarte uploaded another video with good old Shaz, reassuring us that a filter wasn't used. How can you deny that? And in fact, their product does help, in their own words, does a lot to help blur their appearance when talking about pores. However, this video was called out again. The product on the skin looks completely different in this video to the original video that they posted. It's gone from 100% poreless blur to a pretty obvious, basically mattifying primer. In my opinion, this video, they shot themselves in the foot with this because it just further solidifies the fact that they were using such a heavy filter in the first video. When we look at the video, we see areas of the skin jumping and glitching into a blur, areas of the skin which seem to be out of focus for no reason compared to the area of skin right next to it. And of course, we see this really what they thought was a sneaky cut. Where the blur kicks in, it's so poorly done. There are apps, there are programs where you can track a blur, so you can do that and assure that only the blur ends here. It's very simple to do. Now, we do have to take into consideration that Instagram does compress videos a lot. I've been told that there's an option to upload higher quality videos. I've not seen it. I experienced this issue with some of my videos as well. And I'll often get tagged in videos where people think that a filter's been used when really it is just a poor quality video. So your skin is gonna look a little bit blurred. You're not going to pick up all those tiny details that show real skin. However, we can see on Tarte's profile that this hasn't been an issue before. We've seen a lot of close-up products being demonstrated. Here you can see them side by side and we're not experiencing that same blur, glitching, blur jumping. I've worked in social media before. I've done social media for a lot of brands and I don't understand what Tarte were thinking. Any good company will have a team that works for their social media and every post is done at least a week in advance, at least, and should go through a rigorous approval process. I'm not sure this was approved because later in the day after making a statement about this video, they actually posted on LinkedIn that they were looking for a new social media manager. Hopefully this is just a coincidence and hopefully our Shaz is okay. After sharing this supposed, in my opinion, overly filtered video over on Instagram and on Twitter, I received a lot of DMs saying that they actually weren't surprised by this kind of behavior from Tarte. And being primarily a makeup brand, I don't know a lot about Tarte, to be honest with you. I didn't even know they did skincare until like a month ago. But yes, Tarte do have a history of shady behavior. From an intern posting racist memes on their social media, for absolutely failing to cater for black people with their shape tape launch. You can Google Tarte's net worth and their revenues and their income, and you can see they have enough money for a proper social media team and to be able to produce an inclusive collection. I can't talk about that much, but there are some great videos out there that go into detail about this. I missed the boat on this. I'm not 100% sure what happened. Whatever it was wrong. So let's get into using the actual product. This is makeup, I guess, right? So I'm not overly familiar with makeup, but what I'm gonna do is actually ignore the instructions on the box, and we're gonna follow the video and use it exactly how Shana used the product. On their website, they say that this is a skincare-infused primer, delivers a filtered, soft focus finish, innovative blurring and filling technology, and this even more pushes the idea that they use the filter to exaggerate their claims. Smooths appearance of pores, fine lines and wrinkles, provides perfect canvas to enhance wear of makeup. Perfect within skincare and makeup is another red flag word for me. So they say it's a skincare infused primer. It contains vitamin E. They say this is a natural preservative and acts as an anti-inflammatory ingredient. Vitamin C, which is an antioxidant. And this is where I think the pore minimizing claims come in. Brands can make these type of claims on skincare. And I think they're saying here because they got green bean extract, which they say is known for anti-wrinkle and pore minimizing properties. Not a lot of research done on that. That doesn't mean that it's not true. It just means it's possibly unlikely or there's no evidence. They also say mineral pigments which soothe and soften the skin. So when we look at the ingredients, there's not much that sets it apart from other primers. There's nothing in here that's going to give you that miracle smoothing, poreless look. We have silica in here that can matten the skin, mica, which can reflect light, and vinyl dimethicone, which can give the skin a silky, blurred look. However, it's not gonna make it look like a filter. Or will it? We don't know, we're gonna test it. Okay, let's try it. I'm gonna zoom in, I'm gonna watch this video, and we're gonna do a side-by-side comparison. This is a 4K camera, so you're gonna see a lot of detail that you might not necessarily see on the phone. We're gonna see the real effects. I'm also gonna record on the front camera of my phone and then upload it into Instagram so we can see if any compression was the issue. It feels very smooth. It's got kind of like a jelly consistency to it. You see a lot of pores here, right? Go for this texture under my eye. I don't know if you're meant to put primer this high up, but let's see. Oh, I need to trim my nose hair. Let's do it here. I mean, it's definitely mattifying. I wouldn't say it's filtering or smoothing. You can still see that I have pores. Really, for me, that's just mattifying my skin and taking away that shine kind of takes a reflection off your bigger pores, so you don't see them as much. Let's record it on my front camera on my phone. I'm shooting on an iPhone 12 something Pro. In fact, if anything, God, that's terrible, that's terrible. In fact, if anything, my front camera actually shows up way more than you can see in real life. Oh, that's horrible. And as you can see, when uploaded into Instagram Reels, there's a tiny bit of compression, but nowhere near the blurring effect that happens here. If it was a real compression issue, her whole face would be blurred. You won't be able to see these standout pores here and there. There we go, what a surprise. It didn't blur the skin at all. This is clearly a filter being used. And the fact that they had the cheek to deny that a filter was being used takes the piss out of us. The fact that they think that we're that stupid, uneducated, and pretty much blind to seeing what they're doing. It takes the piss. It's obviously a brand that doesn't respect its consumers, in my opinion. The weird thing is this product gets amazing reviews. It gets great feedback. A lot of the feedback was actually, why are you doing this? You don't need to do this. This is such a good primer. There's no need to use a filter to exaggerate what it does. I mean, sure, it doesn't get rid of your pores and smooth out your skin just like that. No one really believes that. But looking at my skin now, taking away that little bit of shine does add a smoothness to my skin. It's a primer. What I love about this is that the brand was called out in the first place. My stance on filters is knock yourself out. Have fun with them. Create whatever you want to create with filters, Photoshop, Facetune. But if you're selling me a product that claims to do certain things to your skin and you have to lie in order to prove that, because your product doesn't actually do that, that's where I have an issue. I mean, it's a good, my skin looks nice, I don't mind it, I don't mind this slightly mattified effect, but it just doesn't do what it says it's gonna do. Stop it, like, don't do it. Let me know what you think in the comments below, and also brands that you've seen using filters in order to sell their products. I'll leave my Instagram versus reality playlist here, and some general light entertainment here, and I'll see you over there.